video discovered that there is a resource that needs to be protected. And today Steve will tell us about this. Please welcome Steve Elliot, Precious Resource.
Have you ever looked at a water bottle and really thought about how do they get water in here? I mean, it sounds like a silly question, but where does water come from that goes into these water bottles?
Aberfoyle.
Today, I'm going to share with you some information I got about the business of bottling water. And at the end, I have a call to action for everyone in this room. So let's dive in to our precious resource. We're going to look at, water by the numbers. 300 billion bottles of water are sold globally. And not going down this road for too much, but I will tell you that it's estimated that only about 20% of that number actually make it into a recycling facility. So you're looking at a bulk of those bottles going into either landfill, or we've seen lots of videos online about the oceans now being polluted with plastic. This number, that's the profit last year of Nestle, who happens to be the number one water seller in the world. They make huge profits. That's over $7 billion in profit. That's profit. That's not sales. That's profit they're taking to the bank. This is how much it costs Nestle to pump water from a well in Michigan. They pay $200. And they can pump as much water as they want out of that well and bottle it up into bottles for us to consume. So needless to say, they're making a lot of money on water. Now, I got my calculator out and I thought, how many bottles of water does Pork Credit Toastmasters consume in a year? And that's the number I came up with, a conservative estimate. 45 meetings for the year, 25 bottles put out, we're looking at over 1,000 bottles of water that we're purchasing every year, just this club on a Monday night. Now I'd like to talk to you about the statistics. So I mentioned they pay Michigan $200 for the right to pump out water. They're pumping out 250 gallons a minute in that facility, one of the springs that they have in Michigan. And they've recently applied to up that to 400 gallons per minute. Since 2005, the Nestle company has taken from Michigan 350 million gallons of water have come out of the state of Michigan to be consumed by us in water bottles. Unlike oil and gas, the state of Michigan does not charge an extraction fee. So the fee, the cost that the company pays the government is $200 for the year. No other additional fees are applied to that. Well, that's all the economics and that's what Nestle is doing. And I should stand here and tell you, I don't begrudge a company making money. That's what capitalism is all about and I heartily support it. But you do have to wonder, when it's a natural resource, what impacts does it have beyond the profit it's making for a company? So let's look at the environmental side. And this is where things get tricky. The community in Michigan is revolting against Nestle and their plans to raise to 400 gallons per minute. Why? If you were to drive around in some of the smaller towns of Michigan and you were to look at the water bridges and culverts, you would see a water line here, a water line mark here, and then one here, and then you would see where the current water line is. In some cases, the water levels in Michigan have dropped more than 5 feet. There is a substantial loss of water. When they applied to increase to 400 gallons, 80,000 comments were against Nestle having the right to do so. Only 75 comments were in favor of Nestle upping their pumping facility. It's even got native treaties involved because there is the Ohio and Chippewa tribe that has water rights in Michigan. They are now seeing that their trout and fish stock have dropped dramatically because the water levels have dropped. And when the water levels dropped, the temperature of the water has risen and trout do not flourish in warm water. They need cold water. Insult to injury, I vaguely remember this story, but Flint, 4 years ago, decided they were going to change where they got their water from. Instead of getting it from Lake Michigan, they were going to do a cost-saving move, and they were going to now get their water from Flint River. The water from Flint River was not properly treated, and as such, the pipes of Flint eroded and got corroded, and lead poisoning was given to the entire citizenry of Flint, which is about 80,000 people. Many people died. The government has since improved the water quality, but Nestle continues to pump out of their springs unabated. They were providing the residents of Flint with free water in the form of water bottles. That now has gone away because the government is saying, oh no, your water supply is fine. The residents are skeptical on that front. These are just some of the facts that I uncovered watching that little YouTube video when I was feeling somnolent and up late at night. It should cause you to look at this product a little differently. By the way, this is the number one selling drink now in North America. It surpasses Coke and Pepsi and all the sodas you can buy. So I challenge you, stop purchasing water bottles, or at least curtail your purchase of water bottles. Look to invest in a sustainable water bottle where you can put in tap water or filtered water that is just as good. You're going to find you're doing the environment better, and you're also going to stop the landfill mess that is occurring within our society. The other option is to contact Nestle directly and voice your concerns and your opinions. They don't only pump water out of Michigan, they are a global company based out of Switzerland, and they do the same practices all over the world. So look for sustainable, avoid the water bottle, and let's keep our precious resource of water protected. An answer.